mitigating the adverse effects of implicit bias in rankings. This is a joint work with my advisors, Elisa Celis and Nishit Vishnoi at Yale University. So implicit bias is the unconscious association of certain qualities with members of some subpopulation, such as those based on, say, race or gender. It is understood that implicit bias can be a factor in adverse outcomes against these subpopulations. For instance, one study found that resumes with white-sounding names receive more callbacks for interviews than similar resumes with African-American-sounding names. Other studies have also associated implicit bias with adverse outcomes in other contexts, such as in medicine or in education. We specifically look at these adverse effects in the ranking problem, where we have to select a subset of candidates and order them in decreasing order of their utilities. Such ordered lists of candidates have applications in various settings, for example, when you are hiring someone for a job or when you are admitting candidates to a university. In such ordered lists, the candidates who are placed later in the ranking are less likely to receive positive outcomes such as being called for an interview. And yeah, so one direction to mitigate such adverse effects could be to educate people actually generating these rankings about their implicit biases. However, such programs have been shown to have like limited efficacy in practice. And this really calls for an intervention-based approach where we can have stronger guarantees on the kinds of outputs we get. Now, this problem has, like such interventions have been studied for the subset selection problem, which is a special case of the ranking problem where you have to select a subset of candidates, but the order, but their order is not very important. One popular constraint here which has been used in practice is the Rooney rule, which forces the committee hiring the candidates to interview at least one underprivileged candidate before actually selecting anyone for the job. Right. And the idea behind the Rooney rule is that it gives an opportunity to talented underprivileged candidates to participate in the job selection process, which they otherwise may not receive because of the biases in the committee. Right. And this has been analyzed, this was recently analyzed by Kleinberg and Raghavan, and they showed that applying the Rooney rules in certain settings, in certain conditions, could improve the utility of the subset of candidates selected, right? So we consider a model of implicit bias which was introduced by Kleinberg and Raghavan. So suppose we have two individuals, A and B, who have utility like 20 and 14. If you knew these utilities, it's clear that we'll choose the left individual over the right one, but you only see a biased version of these utilities, where like for a fixed factor beta between 0 and 1, we reduce the utility of the underprivileged candidates by this factor. Right. For instance, in this example, we reduce the utility of the left candidate from 20 to 10. So in absence of any interventions here, we end up choosing the less talented right candidate over the more talented left one. Right. This is also bad for the hiring committee because they're losing out on good candidates. Right. We look at the ranking problem where we have to output a sorted list of N candidates. We divide the group of candidates into two. We partition the group of candidates into two parts, G1 and G2, where we take G2 to be the underprivileged group of candidates. The utility we get by placing the ith candidate at the jth position is Wi times Vj, where Vj is some position-based discount which decreases as you go further in the ranking. So this is encoding for the fact that people who are placed later in the ranking are less likely to receive positive outcomes. Right? Ideally, if we knew these latent or true utilities of the individuals, we can just sort them according to these utilities. However, we only observe a biased version of them, and so traditionally the outputted ranking tries to maximize the sum of observed utilities. Right? So for instance, we show like the ranking which maximizes the observed utility on the right. It tends to place the underprivileged candidates later in the ranking rather than earlier. And while the person who is generating this ranking thinks that they are getting the optimal utility, as we can see in this example, they are actually losing out on a large fraction of the optimal utility. Our goal then is to design constraints on the output ranking such that it retains a high latent utility. The first assumption we make is that the distribution of utility of the candidates is the same, irrespective of their group. This seems reasonable as we expect candidates of different groups to have similar abilities. In our first result, we show that for any distribution of utilities you choose, in the optimal ranking, in the top k positions of the optimal ranking, you expect to see a proportional number of underprivileged candidates with high probability. Right? Whereas in the traditional ranking, we tend to choose less underprivileged candidates. Right? So this motivated us to use lower bound constraints, where you can specify the minimum number of candidates from a particular group you would want to see in the top k positions of the ranking. Now, similar constraints are known to encapsulate a wide range of fairness metrics, but it's not clear whether whether these constraints are useful when mitigating implicit bias. So in particular, we look at constraints which force the ranking to pick at least a proportional number of candidates in every top K position. And so these are shown in the red, in red. And looking at these constraints with the traditional ranking, we can see that the ranking tends to violate these constraints, in particular in the second row. The ranking violates the constraint since it doesn't select any underprivileged candidates in the top two positions. Right? Similarly, it violates these constraints at the fourth and the fifth position, as it didn't pick at least two underprivileged candidates in the top four and five positions, respectively. Like, comparing this to the ranking which satisfies the interventions, we see that the ranking tends to place the underprivileged candidates higher up in the ranking, which is what we expected. And in this particular example, it also ends up recovering most of the utility we lost. So it gets like 488, where the optimal is 492. In our next result, we show that for certain specific distributions, the ranking which satisfies these interventions would always get a nearly optimal fraction of the latent utility, where assuming we have some natural assumptions on the position-based discounts, which are satisfied by popular metrics such as DCG, which are used in practice. Next, we also empirically examine the performance of our interventions on real-world distributions of utility. Here we find that these interventions are robust to deviations from our assumptions. So in conclusion, we propose interventions to mitigate the adverse effects of implicit bias in ranking. These constraints appear to be robust to deviations from our assumptions, but still it's important to test their performance as a part of a larger system so that we can better understand their usefulness in practice. So thank you.